first bus leaving the high school. Gotta turn on my lights.
Okay, turn your left under your yard gauges.
They don't stay up usually. They're usually stuck. It's a thing that happens on these older buses. I am sorry, please. Amy, you want to turn up the heat? They're on the right.
Here?
This guy is me. I'm here for an hour.
Turn it off.
That's up. Up is off.
Off.
Turn it on.
Yeah. They're off.
Makes it easier to spot.
There.
Yeah, I want it on.
On. Oh, okay. No.
It's in a funny spot, I know.
Scarlet. Heaters are on.
Yay, thank you. I love being warm.
How did we get this bus again?
Fighting.
You did this, didn't you?
I have nothing to do with it.
You gave us a really cold bus.
I have nothing to do with it, I promise. I like this bus too, but I don't like how cold it is.
Yeah, nobody likes that.
I think that's what they are.
Take this a snow aisle too. One happy guy.
There's many lighting, and I should have pushed the windows up, but I was too busy looking at the lights and making sure everything was safe.
Yeah, I love that about these older buses. You can just see.
Just smile. Yeah. Just
definitely. I almost started doing it. I like it. It feels a little more open in that regard, in addition to the lower seats.
What? It just feels like there's so much space. Yeah.
It's about the same amount of space on your normal bus.
Yeah.
It's taken up by laps. And I love it.
Yeah.
We'll see, how long it takes for us to get up to speed if we get up to speed.
Oh, absolutely. Are you sure? What if you get like another boat spike?
In the middle of the bus ride?
No, if we keep this bus.
We're not.
I doubt it.
We're not.
That's
this bus is on a different route.
That's why this bus is terrible.
just eat on here for the whole bus ride?
How's this stinker to go?
Not at the respect of my
temperature sensibilities. What part of Texas, by the way? We had in middle school, right, Ella?
Yeah.
Alex. Alex was a great guy, I just didn't like his bus. It's just now realized I don't think we've talked on the bus since then.
Yeah.
Like, unless my memory's, you know, just dead or something.
Freshman year, I switched buses like
3 times. Like routes or the bus itself?
Like, it was routes. Because they were trying to figure out where they could fit me in.
Yeah. That was my sophomore year. That was when I started driving again. Because I didn't ride freshman year because there wasn't really much for my freshman year. And then when we got in, Mom was like, you can't go until you got vaccinated for COVID, which is fair enough. I don't want to die.
Yeah.
I've been on the same route since 281. Is it bus 81?
81.95.
I'll speak for myself. I'm old because there's a railroad.
My little brother hits high school next year. That's terrifying.
Mine hit high school this year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have the same.
But he's a stinker.
That's cool. Because
he's a little brother.
Yeah. That's just how little brothers are.
I mean, this older sibling problem.
Hey, I get it.
Alright, we're at 206. This is where you start doing my job.
Your first
stop.
Here comes Quality Community.
Okay. Yeah, it's already marked. Then your next stop after that's 85th.
Is it 85th?
That's what I had shown.
Yeah. When your parents have more than one kid, that's what a sibling is.
Yeah.
That's how they work.
Yeah, but all the other stuff.
All the other stuff? Well, when you grow up with someone, it can result in that they're not your parents.
That is true.
Yeah.
Until parents hear that you're talking back to your sibling, and they're like, what the hell? Stop.
Yeah.
And I go, man. this.
If you're older, if you're older, you try to be in charge, and usually you succeed. If you're younger, you get bossed around a lot. And if you're smack in the middle, no one cares about you.
See, my experience is the opposite. The little brother is bossing. There's this strange feeling of camaraderie sometimes.
Yeah.
When you're working with your sibling on something, or if there's like something that you mutually despise or love. There's this strange sense of camaraderie of like, yeah, we can do it.
Yeah.
I don't know how to describe it. Right.
Especially if you and your sibling, my parents try and or if they're annoying the crap out of you, you can't just say, hey, I don't really want to hang out right now. They're always there.
Yeah, you're stuck with them for life.
Yep.
Pretty much.
Oh, speaking of siblings, I got a great video of my brother last night trying to get the ball back from the dog.
Are you able
used to driving.
Thank you.
I have to be done anymore.
Yeah.
love ASL. ASL, I love.
Sorry,
Kevin, we go to
yeah.
the same places. Keep going.
It's the Christmas sign, which is, you really love something.
So. If the Cantwell girls yeah. are on, they're just past.
Stegosaurus.
Are
pretty sure it's not stegosauri.
Stegosauruses.
It's stegosauruses.
That's what it is.
Several stegosauri.
Stegosauruses. I'm not bringing my flute.
You don't have extra instruments.
Yes. It's kind of worse with my trombone. Unless I have a seat to my
three more.
I'm sure it's worse with your trombone, but at least you only have one to carry.
Well, the other option.
I've already dealt with the hell of carrying one large instrument. Carrying two more, regardless of size, sounds like a pain in the ass.
The piccolo doesn't even have a handle on it. What I do is I have a lanyard that I keep my earplugs on, and I tied the lanyard around my piccolo, and that's how I carry it. And then I use that same hand to carry my flute and my two music holders, and the other arm is occupied with the saxophone.
Intelligent, but must be difficult.
It's difficult, yeah. Especially when the piccolo tries to slip out of the lanyard.
What, Amy?
I'm telling these cars to go.
They're not going.
Everybody decided to come this way today.
Yeah, clearly.
Alright,
okay.
Just punch it.
Here we go. Come on,
Amy, zoom in. Go faster!
Olivia left.